Now sit back, relax, and I hope you enjoy. Much love to all.
Mori is officially condemned by devout Muslims. Periodic attempts are made to outlaw it, but the spiritual tradition persists, if only because people tend to resist abandoning spirits who demonstrate healing powers. Women hold prominent positions in Bori spiritual traditions. Other names for Bori spirits include Iska, plural, Ishoki, which literally means wind, and Aljin, derived from the Arabic word jinn. The Bori are frequently identified as jinn, spirits who are acknowledged in the Quran and thus more palatable from an Islamic perspective. However, Bori spirits preceded jinn in the region. Bori more closely resemble Zar spirits but are described as less capricious. Individual Bori spirits can develop extremely close, positive relationships with people, although they can be demanding, expecting constant attention and offerings. Like LWA, Orishas, and Zar spirits, each Bori prefers specific colors, numbers, offerings, fragrances, rhythms, songs, and dances. Bori engage in ritual possession. Each Bori possesses a specific song that celebrates and summons them. Bori ritual leaders are also herbal specialists. Each Bori is associated with specific botanicals. Bori tend to demonstrate anger and displeasure by gradually sucking away someone's life force. The key word is gradually. Opportunity is left, usually, to make offerings, conduct ceremonies, or otherwise appease, placate, and propitiate the spirit. Bori spirits are devotees, too. Some are Muslim, others maintain a pagan path. There are an infinite number of Bori, but only approximately 100 to 300 are actively involved with people. Bori spirits live like people. They get married, have children, and belong to families. They have their own city, Jangare, where they live in 12 houses divided by family, ethnicity, and occupation. Bori are traditionally invoked to bless beginnings, new homes, business ventures, marriages, or births. They are also invoked for healing, but the relationship between Bori spirits and illness is complex. Bori spirits cause human illness and misfortune and then provide the remedy. They may cause illness and bad luck because they are angry or annoyed, but they also cause it as a way of indicating their interest in a person. Each Bori is associated with specific ailments or misfortunes, which they have the power to cure even when they are not the cause. Each ailment is essentially a calling card for a specific Bori spirit. Bori are also associated with more nebulous disorders, general incompetence, clumsiness, and the inability to do anything right are all considered signs of Bori affliction. Ceremonies are held to heal these afflictions. The healing ritual is simultaneously an initiation. The newly healed individual is expected to become a trance medium, a vehicle for the particular Bori and an active participant in future rituals. Antidote: iron repels the Bori. Even the word iron, whether spoken or written, may be sufficient to send them packing. Realm. The Bori spirits live in an invisible city named Jangare, where they live in 12 houses or Zoran. First house. House of the chief of spirits, inhabited by the chief's family, bodyguards, metal workers, and blind spirits. Second house. House of the chief's brother. Third house. House of Quranic scholars. Fourth house. House of lepers and snakes. Fifth house. House of the Fulani spirits. Sixth house. House of the younger brother of the Fulani chief, incorporating the house of butchers and the house of musicians. Seventh house. House of water spirits. Eighth house. House of the hunters, including spirits identified by the Hausa as Tuareg. Ninth house. House of the chief of pagans. 10th house, house of the chief of Gwari, also pagan spirits. 11th house, house of the North Africans. 12th house, house of magicians and sorcerers.
Thank you for watching. I hope to see you again soon. Till the next time, much love.